Being a dork may not be a title most people embrace, but the Russell family has turned that into a hugely profitable business. Rachel Renée Russell is the author of the hit graphic novels, Dork Diaries. They follow the life of an awkward teenage girl muddling her way through middle school. The 11 Dork Diary books have more than 36 million copies in print in 37 different languages.
Wow. Daughters Erin and Nikki Russell helped inspire the novels and also contributed by co-writing and illustrating the books. The team is out with a new book. It's The Misadventures of Max Crumbly, Middle School Mayhem. Now, this is about a gawky teenage boy with superhero ambitions. This is the second book in their newest series. It's published by Aladdin Books, which is an imprint of Simon & Schuster, which, as you know, is a division of CBS. Rachel, Erin, and Nikki Russell, welcome to the table.
Good morning.
So nice to meet you guys.
That's so exciting to be here.
I'm excited, too, because these books are huge. So you decided to write about a boy. Is it much harder writing for boys than it is writing about boys and girls?
It's a little bit more challenging, only because I had two daughters.
Yes.
But with boys, it's just more action and thrills, and things move a lot faster.
I love that you wrote this second Max book with the purpose of having humor, quote, be a Band-Aid to help emotional wounds heal. What did you mean by that?
Well, even our day-to-day lives, it can get kind of traumatic. And, of course, being, 12, 13, 14 in middle school, you have your homework, teachers, parents, and then trying to fit in with your peers. So we feel writing this humorous series helps.
It does.
You ever ask yourself, why me?
No, not really. I'm glad it's me. Yes. Like, this is all a blessing, So the whole author experience has been wonderful.
Erin, you help with the writing and you do the illustrations.
That's correct.
I love the illustrations. I love what you do with the eyes.
Thank you.
Do you draw on your own personal experiences in this book about middle school? Do you go back to your middle school days?
With Max Crumbly and with Nikki Maxwell, they're both really dorky outsiders, and so I do draw on my childhood for that.
Is dorky good?
It is.
Why? Because when I was growing up, nobody wanted to be a dork, Erin.
Right. Dorks are underestimated and misunderstood because they think uniquely and they do their own thing, but really it's good to be that way. It's good to be independent and to embrace your uniqueness.
Your inner dorkness.
Yes.
We wanted dorks to become a good, positive thing. So you're right, it was something bad.
Uh-huh.
But now it's good, and it's a term of empowerment.
Nikki, I'm always fascinated by families that can work together. They can get along personally, but can you work together? How is that dynamic?
Well, we always need to keep in mind that we're a team, so it's important to focus and keep a goal we agree upon in mind. And if ever we do not quite agree on something, my little secret is that I go to my own personal little space, because we all work in my mother's home and she provided a home office for us. I go there and I just sort of let it roll off my shoulders, because I know I can kind of be a bit of an artiste where I have this particular vision in mind, but it's not just about me. It's about fulfilling the vision that we all have together. And so I just chill and try to meet that goal.
Where did the name Max Crumbly come from?
I just thought Max was a cool name, and it's pretty common. And then Crumbly is kind of a take on crummy, like my crummy life. So Max Crumbly.
But at one point, you could say you had a crummy life. You were going through a divorce. This is how this is all started.
Oh, yes.
That you were going through a divorce. You said, we need money to support the family.
Exactly. The house had gotten foreclosed on. Cars had gotten repossessed. And I kind of needed to jumpstart my career.
So what does Mr. Man, known as your ex-husband, say about this success? Because it's huge.
Yeah, it is. He's a wonderful father to my daughters. So
yes.
He's happy for
something
all of
nice.
Us.
Yes, I agree.
Nice thing to do.
I say that, too, about my ex. Wonderful husband, wonderful father. Yes. Cheering you on?
Yes, especially them more so probably than me, but yeah, he's
you have a great line, Renée, where you say, become the hero you've always admired.
Exactly. That is the theme of Max Crumbly, and he's again a dorky guy, kind of quiet, and he gets put in a position where he can become a hero, and he doesn't think he can do it, but as he goes through the story, he realizes he has that in him. So
what is the writing process? I'm curious, back to what Norah was saying about how you work together and write together. What's your process with your mom? Because you help her, you guys co-write it.
Yeah, we will bounce ideas off of each other. What do you think about this? And then maybe this should happen. And I'll take some chapters and she will write the majority of it. And then it works pretty well. Like, our comedy or sense of humor, they blend pretty well. When it gets close to a deadline, we might get a little crabby. But otherwise, we work well.
Erin has a wicked sense of humor, so I may do a lot of the plotting, but she does a lot of the wit and the humor and the...
And Nikki brings
and,
it
and
home
that's important.
Yeah, with the illustration.
Yep. I try to jump in and draw whenever I can.
Well, you know what? You're encouraging more kids to read. They love these books, so congratulations to
all
of you.
Thank you.
Thank you
so
very much.
That's always a good thing. Rachel, Erin, and Nikki Russell, we're glad to see you in the table in person. The Misadventures is the name of their book. The Misadventures of Max Crumbly Middle School Mayhem, that's a good word, is on sale right now.